kipping movements, even strict movements, and it'll even translate to some barbell movements. So we're gonna have Mitchell show a few things. A lot of times, we have people who struggle with kipping movements or getting pull-ups, and one of their biggest problems is how they're hanging on a bar. So we're gonna start with kind of like the most common fault in hanging. And a lot of times people really go down in their fingers. We can get a little closer, and they'll be hanging and just have their fingertips on the bar. Maybe a little more than that, that would be extreme. But we have a really straight wrist. We only have our fingertips, the very, very top of our palm. So really only those muscles that can attach to our fingers and make our fingers move are working. Not really those muscles that engage our wrist flexion. So what we wanna do is we wanna make sure we have our wrist a little cocked over the bar. So it's bent, it's flexed some, and he's in a better grip position. So now his forearm is working harder. He has more strength, more ability to pull. He's gonna be able to create more power, okay? So anytime we get on a bar, we want a little bit of that wrist motion here. We never wanna hang straight. Goes for hanging on rings as well, and then even a barbell movement. So if I'm gonna pull like a snatch, I don't really wanna be here with my wrists open. I wanna make sure I'm in this position so I have more of an ability to pull on the bar. So that's a pretty easy change for people to make that might make a big difference. The other thing that's important with grip is we get a lot of questions, especially in gymnastics club, about thumb over, thumb under. My answer is typically always whatever is most comfortable for you. So a lot of people will naturally just go thumb over. A lot of people with bigger hands can even almost have, you can see how Mitchell's thumb goes over his finger. So that's kind of like a gymnastics hook grip. And it's gonna help your grip a little bit. People with smaller hands have a really hard time doing that, and it might be less comfortable to have their thumb around so that we can also go thumb over. There's definitely some people who are worried about that being a worse grip and people slipping off a bar, but I would say you're probably just as likely to slip off a bar from weak grip strength or if you try to hang on too long. So you just wanna make sure that you're in whatever's comfortable, and I would actually suggest to people, if you're really proficient at one way, so I typically go thumb over. Female gymnasts, for the most part, swing bars with their thumb over. But I can go thumb around, and it actually changes where the bar is on my hand, so I get rips in different places then, or it can actually make my grip stay longer. So I work out with a ton of toes to bar, or a ton of pull-ups can be helpful to do some thumb under and some thumb over. So takeaway points, just make sure you're really working on that wrist being over the bar here, so more of your palm is on the bar, and then maybe mix up thumb around, thumb over from time to time. So let us know if you have any questions. Make sure that you're kind of following along, because we're gonna put up a lot of tip videos like this. So let us know if you have any questions.